Alright. Time for dinner today. I didn't... Well, it's nice to have Gourmet Race in this game. I didn't think it was, but... Hey. Iconic theme, say. Oh gosh! No. Anything over here? Absolutely jackal. That was a waste of time. No! Why? I've ever seen those animations. Alright, I remember this. Probably shouldn't have killed that guy, but... What's the point of this place? Oh. That's the first time an enemy has had one of those. Yeah, this level is just going crazy with these exclamation mark things. Like, tear off the Waddle Dee pictures, but don't even touch the King Dedede ones. Come on. No, don't do that. Alright, don't pound. So, pretty cool though, because it basically plays with what you're used to by that point. Is it that one? It's gonna be hidden in one of these things. It's just there's no telling where it is. And can I even get this now? Yes. Okay, it was just in one of the enemies. Okay, is this gonna be the second gift or second treasure? No, it's just gonna be that. Oh well. Please don't tell me it's gonna be in one. Okay. I really don't wanna have to deal with a multiple choice route right now. I'm cool with, I'm cool with, alternate paths in games, but, when I'm actively trying to look for, certain items and stuff, it can be a little bit annoying. Well, mainly the ones where you can't go back, go through three specific pathways or something, and if you chose the wrong one, sucks to be you, play the whole level again. If I'm just playing for fun and I'm not worrying about that, I'm totally fine with those kinds of, that kind of level design. I think, Sonic games are, one of the, I think Sonic does, multiple pathways, the best I played anyway for multiple paths. Not every game in the series, but their games it does do multiple paths, when it's a main focus of the level design, I think it excels with that really well. And I mean, Sonic games are some of the few where I'm not too fussed about replaying levels to get things. It's fast paced, so the levels by their nature aren't gonna be very long. And they're fun to go through, so it's not really a massive task to have to replay levels most of the time. It depends, but yeah. But when it's a slow-paced game like this, and the levels are pretty lengthy because of that, and you have to go back and find the treasure you missed, or you have to get the gold, it's a lot more demanding feeling because of that. I just die. I guess I just had to kill all the enemies. Alright. Oh! Yeah, what gave her away? Was it too obvious for you? Oh, hey. That's kind of cool looking. We gotta take the castle back. We gotta take our world back. Alright, cool. Flawless victory. Now it's time for the final showdown. I think. Seems like it, yep. Hi. hold on. I forgot about this. Okay. I don't really remember this fight too much, so this will be interesting. Oh, okay, yeah, it's like a boss rush at the start, isn't it? Yeah. Okay. Alright. Yeah, do your thing. Alright, I still need to get the patch. Alright, it's just one hit. Oh, what the hell? No! I could've... I see what... Okay, I see. I can't do it like that. I'm gonna use some like platforms. I don't need you. Oh, what the hell? Oh, hey. Oh, this boss? I like how it didn't even bother showing up in any of the other ones. Alright. Can I use a power from this? Ah! No! I think I could. Oh, okay, okay. Alright. Oh my gosh, why? Oh my gosh, why? This music though, I swear this isn't an original piece. I'm pretty sure this theme's in another game. Or maybe it's original for this game and it was reused in another game after this. Oh, come on, no! Oh, come on, big guy. Well, you're not really big right now, but... Wait, can I hit him with these? Actually. Oh yeah, that's okay. That works. Nice. Right. No. Give me that star. No. Oh, you suck. Alright. Me. Day! Oh gosh. I'm gonna have to use this guy then. Yep. Taste it. Oh, this... this is kinda cute. But why do we need that? He's not done yet. Hey! Yeah, Prince Fluff is just like, screw this, man. So now you just kind of spam missiles in his face. There's not a lot to this phase. I guess it's kind of cool to have a tank fight as the final boss. Not giving me as much... oh gosh. I forgot about this move. It's not giving me as much bees as I'd like right now. Please, no, I don't have to fight you again. Okay. You like your spinning, I see. Gonna do anything besides that. Okay. That's a good amount. Almost. Yes! Okay, he's done. I think for good. I don't think there's another phase. Whew. Hi, Patchland, just there for some reason. That is kind of clever, though. So, why is there a magic charm piece there? Like, we've already finished up Patchland. Why would we need it over here? You know, it's kind of clever.
With Yin Yan's spell broken, Dreamland returned to its normal state of peace and quiet.
Hooray!
Well, I guess this is goodbye, Fluff said. It made Kirby sad to see his new friend leave.
Aw.
Buck up, Kirby. As long as you have this magic sock, you can visit me anytime. Until then, Fluff said as he returned to Patchland. And that's the story of how Kirby and Prince Fluff defeated Yin Yan the Sorcerer and restored peace to Dreamland.
And now we're going back to the game and it's still Yan. Alright. It's gonna play credits now, isn't it? Alright. Okay then, so... I guess for final thoughts, I do like this game. Like, it's not really a game I go back to very often, but it's kind of just a nice, relaxing game to play. It's not really that difficult. Like, I kind of, like, there are a few times where it got a little bit annoying, like having to go back to get a few gold medals, but, and like trying to get a specific treasure that I missed, but besides that, it's a very relaxing game. Like, if you're just trying to get from the end, get from the point A to point B, like beat Yin Yang and call it a day, like, this is a very peaceful, easygoing game. There's not really too much, too much difficulty, like, bringing it, like, down to make it, like, really challenging in a lot of ways. Like, there's not really much challenge in this game, so if you want something that's more hardcore, and you want to be at your A game, this isn't really a platforming game for you. Like, this would be more for those, I'd say this would be a good, very good beginner platformer, like someone who wants to just get into the genre. This would be a decent place to start, I'd say, because it's not really that demanding from the player. And like I said, if you just want to get to Yin Yang, it's very, very easy, very straightforward. You don't have to worry too much, and you know, it's a pretty fun game. Like, it doesn't blow me away, but I'd still say that I do have quite a lot of enjoyment out of this one. And like I've said, it's just kind of a fun game to sit back and relax to, and not have to worry about having to like play super well and get super, like, really high rankings or anything like that, or like challenging platforming. Which, not to say that there's no challenge whatsoever, there are a few times where you have to think about what you're doing, but it never becomes too demanding. Excuse me. It never becomes that demanding, and I mean, because of that, makes it very easy for beginners. And rest in peace, Iwata. But yeah, fun game, pretty relaxing music, light-hearted story. It's a bit cheesy, I guess, but it works for this kind of game. And yeah, what else can I say? Fun game, and I'd recommend it. Like, it's very different from a regular Kirby game, but I'd say that if you're a big Kirby fan, I'd recommend this game, because it's actually pretty fun, and it does have some, oh, this is pretty nice. I don't remember this, but
the next day, Kirby fell asleep in some shade. He dozed happily with wonderful dreams and held the reminder of a dear friend, even though it smelled a bit.
Okay, that was kind of random. Ah, hey. Very nice. But yeah. Good game. I like this game. Nice. Oh. Okay. So we weren't done with that place. Alright, well, we're gonna go back in and see the completion. 94%. We're almost there, guys. Just a little bit more. Alright. Okay, I know for a fact I haven't played either of these levels, so I'm pretty sure the sixth level is a space hero, but I don't know about this one. Oh, is it? Oh. Okay, cool. Where's this theme again? Like, I recognize the theme, but I forget what it. Is it Ice Cream Island? I don't know. Oh, this is like a like transformation level. Okay, that's a pretty cool way to end up the game. Then we get this, then we get a space shooter next. So that's cool. Oh, I like how we can make a pass in the water, on the lava, even. Can't kill you. No. Well, that happens. No. Okay, we got that. It's kind of weird how, like, it doesn't feel super intuitive, like, trying to get the water down nearer to you. But, you know. Dolphin time! Ow. Yep. This is. Oh. What? Oh, you. This is the last transformation I want to see. It's a part of the game, so I guess they have to show it. Yeah, I know the battery is low. Alright. Alright, at least this area isn't long. No! No! Okay, we got two. Woo! Okay, I can do the penguin. Alright. This is cool. Ride the rainbow, literally. Okay. Whew. All right, and get the 5 stars, please. Maybe. Come on. No. Oh, I still got it. Okay. Galaxia. Okay. Wow. One more level to go. And go and buy the Galaxia sword patch. You should have a general idea of what it could be.